गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। हाउ आर यू ऑल डूइंग टुडे?
गुड आफ्टरनून अलोका, यू आर फाइन, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम ऑल गुड, थैंक यू। थैंक यू फॉर आस्किंग। ओके एवरीवन, so how was the yesterday's practice? Did you all do the magical to-do list? Anybody wants to share? Maybe write in the...
I will be doing now. I didn't do it yet.
Oh, are you going to do now?
Yes, after the session.
Okay, that's fine. But I hope you write 10 blessings.
Yes, I wrote that in the morning itself.
Yes, yeah. For me, I would like to share my experience. So yesterday, like whole day, I was thinking, and I had some things came up yesterday, and so I started thinking like these are the kind of problems that I want to solve, and I started writing. Can you mute? So I started writing about like four different problems that I wanted to solve. And it was really, I mean, I felt so good that now I'm surrendering to universe and universe will definitely take care of. So, and it's magically when I started writing, so many different things came up in my mind. And it's really amazing. After I wrote my whole list, I felt so good. These were the problems that I really wanted to be solved. And somehow until now, like I was taking it on my own self. And now I'm surrendering to God. So, okay. Let's start our peak state programming. I hope you all are doing the Ho'oponopono shower. The audio link is there. So what you can do is you can go in the group and go into media links and documents. And in the media, you can find this audio very easily because I know it gets lost in the conversations. Okay. Okay. Let's do a peak state programming.
Where is it? Have you sent right now that?
Which one?
In the group. Peak state programming? You said no, you send a link. Yes.
No, I was talking about Ho'oponopono shower.
Okay, that one. Okay. Even this music, can you send?
Yeah, I tried to find, this is the video on YouTube. I sent it earlier, so you can find in the links, in the link section in our group. But okay. I'll try to find if I have an audio. I might have.
That would be better, yes.
Yes, I might have. I think I don't have an audio, but I have a video.
Let me just type that this link of this video. What I'll do, I'll download the video and convert it into the audio and send it again to you.
No, in US I cannot download any videos. It's prohibited.
I will do it.
Oh, okay, yeah. I mean, I might have the video. I can find it in other groups. It's easy for me. You don't have to download.
Okay.
Yeah. If I don't find, then I'll ask you to download. Thank you. Thank you for. Yeah. Thank you. Okay. So let's do it. I mean, actually, you know what? You can do this with any music. You don't just need this particular music. I just like it because it gives me that feeling of, you know, running. That's it. Even I have the Rajan sir's audio, he also talks about this peak state programming, and he has its own music in that audio. I can send you guys that one also. Okay, so it's a complete audio where he is also talking about peak state programming. Okay, let's start. Can you all hear the music? Okay, let's do it on left foot. Run, run, run faster. Like to read today? Manohar ji, would you like to read today?
Yeah, I'll do it, ma'am.
Okay, okay.
One second.
Yeah. Let me share the screen, okay? Sharing the screen. Magical to-do list is a very, very profound practice. It can instantly, I mean, not instantly, but I mean, it can instantly make you feel better about your problems, and also it can solve for you your day-to-day problems. So I have been sending the screenshot. Is it helping you guys? The screenshot that I sent. Wow, today's practice is fully magical. This is one of my favorite practices. Okay, so magical footsteps. Okay, Manoharji. So, what you guys see in this picture? What do you see?
Footsteps in the beach with sparkles or stars.
Yeah, so see, the whole, all this road is filled with magical sparkles. Why? Because it's your footsteps. Very nice. Okay, let's read.
So I'll start now. Day 19, magical footsteps. 100 times every day, I remind myself that my inner and outer self depend on the labors of other men, living and dead, and that I must exert myself in order to give in the same measure as I have received, and I'm still receiving. Albert Einstein, Nobel Prize winner, winning physicist.
So if you know or not, I don't know, but Albert Einstein, he was a very thankful soul, very, very thankful. Like he would always, you know, always think in a way like whatever his life is, it's only and only because of labors of other men in living and dead. So even in the past, people did so many things in the past that we are receiving the benefits today also. So even earlier also, we read in the one of the chapter that Rhonda says that, you know, because of all his thankful heart, all the major discoveries were revealed to Albert Einstein. Do you see how noble the scientist he was? And he made so many discoveries which we use today in our life, daily, day-to-day life. And it's, you know, benefiting the all mankind for years and years and years to come also. Okay, let's read further.
So with those words, Einstein gave us a gift equal to his scientific discoveries. He gave us one of the magical secrets to his success, gratitude, every day. Einstein is the inspiration behind today's magical practice. And you're going to follow in his footsteps to bring success to your life. Today, like Einstein, you will say thank you 100 times and you are going to do it by taking 100 magic footsteps. While it might seem unbelievable to you that taking footsteps can make a difference to your life, you will discover that it is one of the most powerful things you can do.
Yes, so I will explain it a little bit. So, you know, the Einstein is the inspiration behind today's magical practice. So he used to give thanks 100 or maybe 1,000 times in a day because he really, really believed that his life is really depends on people, other people's hard work, you know, other people's efforts. Right now also, if you see in your life, these roads are built by someone, the, you know, airplane is built by those Wright brothers, and then like because of aeroplane we can travel far distances very easily nowadays. So there are so many things, so many discoveries that people did, and because of them we are enjoying everything today. Just like this cell phone, this is our life right now. It's like we cannot live without. If you utilize this phone correctly to your advantage, it is one of the best thing. So whoever discovered this phone, it's really like we need to say thank you to those people. Because of them, because of those people, we are like living a very luxurious life today. So this is very, very imperative to say thanks. And you don't have to say thanks individually, but what you can do is just take 100 steps. And Rhonda will talk how you can do that. Okay, let's read further.
So, William A. Ward, a writer, says, God gave you a gift of 86,400 seconds every day today. Have you used one to say thank you? So, to take magic footsteps, you take one step and in your mind say the magic words thank you as your foot touches to the ground. And then again say thank you as your other foot touches the ground. One foot, thank you. Next foot, thank you. And continue saying the magic words with every footstep. The best thing about magic footsteps is that you can take any number of magic footsteps anywhere and at any time. Through your house, from one room to another, walking to get your lunch or coffee, taking the trash out, walking to a business meeting on your way to catch a cab, train or bus. You can take magic footsteps on your way to anything that is important to you, like exams, a date, a job interview, an audition, to meet a client, to the bank, ATM, dentist, doctor, hairdresser, to see your team play in a sports game, down corridors, through airport terminals, in parks, or from one block to another.
Okay. So from past 8 months, I've been taking magic footsteps almost every day. And whenever, like, you know, things come in your life, like when you don't really feel good, And if I take magic footsteps, immediately it put me in a very good feeling zone. So this particular practice is so close to me. Whenever, especially I take this magic footsteps on a sunset time, because this is that is also very kind of a divine time. When you take a magic wood, like sun is going down. At that time, I really feel so good when I go outside, see the greenery, and I just take a magical footsteps. And I always take more than 100. Like, I mean, 100 you can just do in 60 seconds, one per second, or maybe 1.5 minutes. But I always take, always maybe 1,000 steps or 2,000 steps. What I do also is like my parking spot at my job is a little far. So after I park my car, I always take up magic footsteps. Whenever I walk, most of the time, I just take magic footsteps. And it immediately put me in a, if I'm in already good mood, it will put me in a higher, you know, higher good mood. I mean, exciting mood. So it is really, really a very profound practice. You will tell me that really makes you feel out of the world when you do this magic footsteps practice. Okay, let's read further.
I take magic footsteps around my house, from my bed to my bathroom, kitchen to my bedroom, and outside to my car and the mailbox. Whenever I walk down the street or walk anywhere, I choose a point as my destination. And I put gratitude in my footsteps all the way. So if you take notice of how you're feeling before you begin, then you will notice a big difference in how you feel after you have taken magic footsteps. It doesn't matter if you can't get much of a feeling of gratitude while you're taking them. I promise you will still feel happier afterwards. If you're feeling down, magic footsteps will make you feel better. And even if you're feeling great, magic footsteps will lift your spirits even higher.
Yeah, so as I said, whatever your feelings are, you will feel much better after doing this practice. Believe me, just try this. Really, it works heavenly, seriously. Yeah, you can read further.
So to take the most effective magic footsteps, take magic footsteps for about 90 seconds. This is how long it will take the average person to take 100 steps at a leisurely pace. This practice is not about taking 100 steps exactly, but taking at least that number of steps, because it will probably take that number of footsteps to make a difference to the way you feel. Once you're clear on the approximate distance you can take your 100 steps of gratitude anytime during the day, don't count the footsteps when you're doing the practice, because you will be counting instead of saying thank you, the magic words, with each step.
Yeah, so just, you know, maybe you can just set the timer and do the magic footsteps, maybe 2 to 3 minutes or something like that. So you will definitely cover 100 steps in that 2 to 3 minutes. Or otherwise, just whenever you go for a walk or something, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, just take a magic footsteps instead of, you know, thinking here and there, instead of thinking of worrying thoughts about you, what you're going to do tomorrow, or what you're going to cook tonight, or what you're going to do with your client, things like that. So instead of thinking those problems, and instead of thinking, you know, whatever it is that you think, it's really, really better to say thank you at each step that you take, whenever you go on a walk, or whatever. This is a very, very profound practice. I've been doing it for 8 months. And I always feel much, much better after I take this footsteps. And you got the practice idea, right? So it's very simple. Yeah, it's very simple. Okay.
So lastly, when you have completed today's magical practice, you will have said the magic words, thank you, 100 times. How many days of your life have you said thank you 100 times? And Einstein did it every day.
So when I was in India, and here I don't have to climb the stairs that much, but in India, my mom used to stay at 10th floor. And I really liked the little bit of exercise every day. So I used to climb those 10 stairs every day. And I used to say thank you on each step. And it's really magical. I mean, you can take this any time of the day and anywhere. You can do this practice, maybe while climbing the stairs or while walking or whatever you do, you can do this practice anywhere. And it's really magical. If you are not going out nowadays and whatever, if it's a lockdown or something in your city, that is also fine. You can take these steps in your home, in the comfort of your home also. So, okay, you can read further.
So today's magic practice number 19 is, first is count your blessings. Make a list of 10 blessings. Write why you're grateful. Reread your list. And at the end of each blessing, say thank you, thank you, thank you. And feel as grateful for that blessing as you can. Second step, take 100 magic footsteps for about 90 seconds in gratitude anytime during the day. Third point, with each footstep, say and feel the magic words thank you. And fourth point is, just before you go to sleep tonight, hold your magic rock in one hand and say the magic words thank you for the best thing that happened during the day. Thank you.
Yeah, so today's practice is very easy practice for you to do. I know many of you might not have the practice of writing every day. So you might not be, your mind will say, go in the comfort zone. Your mind will go in the comfort zone. And it's okay. Don't judge yourself right now. Whatever you do, don't go into guilty practice. But yeah, initially you have to push yourself a little bit more than you usually do. So just take this practice as a priority practice for you, because this is changing your life. This is not something that you take it lightly. So I would suggest you all that you do it religiously every single day, all this practice, and just believe me, it is, yeah, I mean, you have been living your life the same way for long years, right? Now you are changing this. So it is, the mind is going to resist it, right? So that is okay. But please believe me, after you build a habit, it will be a second nature to you to write gratitude and to do all these practices very, very easily. So just keep going, trust the process. Again and again, I'm telling. And whenever you feel like not writing or something, just tell yourself that I can do this and I'm the winner. Come out as a winner at that time. Because when you tell your mind that I'm the winner, it will, it will help you writing that practice. So I'm seeing that some of you feel that the writing is really, really, a cumbersome job or whatever, because you never wrote in your whole life. So it's going to take efforts from your side initially. But now for me, writing is so easy. And whenever if I don't have a pen and paper, I always write in my phone. I said earlier also that I have my own personal group on WhatsApp. And I also have notes in my phone. So if I cannot write somewhere, I'm outside and I feel like, during the day, something is realization or some kind of thing that I want to write, I write it down in my phone. So my phone, even notes are full with gratitude practice and with a to-do list and things like that. So feel free to write in your phone if you don't have a pen, paper at that time. But do write. At least writing something is really, really better than nothing. I mean, I would always suggest writing in the paper. But if you cannot, at least write in the phone, because I know everybody's accustomed to typing WhatsApp. So you can do that. That is very easy for you to do. Okay. I'm just giving you the solution. All right. Let's do our heart thought. Today's heart thought is very deep and it's very, very effective heart thought. It's going to change the way you feel. Okay, here. Let me share it. Can you see the heart thought? I hope you can. Okay, so each one of us decides to incarnate upon this planet at particular points in time and space. We have chosen to come here to learn a particular lesson that will advance us on our spiritual evolutionary pathway. So we all are here to learn a lesson. So whatever life circumstances right now, we chose it ourselves to learn a particular lesson. What Louis Hay says is like, we choose everything. So, okay, let the spirit of love flow through you. Go back in time and remember the very best Christmas you ever had as a child. Bring the memory up in your mind and see it very clearly. Remember the sights, the smells, the taste, and the touches, and the people who were there. What were some of the things that you did? If perchance you never had a wonderful Christmas as a child, make one up. So in this practice, if you're not accustomed to Christmas practice, you can choose any of your any celebration of your choice, any maybe Eid or Diwali or whatever. You can choose and you can start remembering the sights, the smell, the taste, touches, everything which brings you joy. You're gonna imagine that. Okay, so as you think of this special Christmas, notice that your heart is opening. Perhaps one of the most wonderful things about that particular Christmas was the love that was present. Let the spirit of love flow through you now. Bring into your heart all the people you know and care about. Surround them with this love. Know that you can carry this special feeling of Christmas love and spirit with you everywhere and have it all the time, not only at Christmas. You are love, you are spirit, you are light, you are energy, and so it is. So we have been like thinking ourselves something completely different than what we are actually. So when we tap into our inner guide and when we tap into our inner powers, we come to know that we are actually love. We are the spirit. We are light. We are energy. And we are so much more than what this body tells us. We are much beyond this body. So this is really powerful practice. What you're going to do is imagine the best time that you ever had, maybe in your childhood, and open your heart, invite the love that is flowing through you. When you think about that particular moments, think of a smell, taste, touch, everything, sight, and then carry this special feeling of love with you everywhere and have it all the time. Okay, so we are very fortunate to get over really, really early today. So let's do our meditation. Everyone ready for the meditation? Yes.
Do you struggle with belly fat and nothing works to get it or keep it off? Then I've got these for you. Just a full
Can you hear the music? Okay, everyone close your eyes. So now, is it better now? Okay, close your eyes. Take a deep breath in. Take a deep breath in. Let your stomach inflate like a balloon. And hold. Hold up to 7 count. Breathe out up to 7. You have to empty your lungs when you breathe out. So that is very important. Again, deep breathe in. Hold. Release. One more time, take a deep breath in. Release. Whenever you meditate, always put your hands facing heaven above. So it should be in a position like facing upward. Okay, now recall the time. Recall the time when you were a child and you had a magical moment at that point. Recall that beautiful memory. And say thank you for that memory. Maybe something good from your childhood. Maybe you met your father after a long time. And he brought a gift for you. Or maybe you and your family went on some trip and you felt really, really good. Or whatever you can recall, a childhood memory. Now feel good about that memory. Try to live that memory again. And say thank you, thank you, thank you, God. Now again, from your youth, try to recall another memory of you. Maybe in the school time, maybe in your birthday party, or you went with a trip with your parents to some place. And it's a very, very good memory for you. Recall that memory. Feel that you are in that moment. And again, say thank you, thank you, thank you, God. Feel that you are living that moment. Feel that happiness and joy that you felt at that time. Maybe you talked the rank in your school and everybody is celebrating your victory. Whatever it is, say thank you. Now go back into the recent past and again find something to be grateful for from the recent past. Some memory that you really want to recollect and relive. Relive that moment again. Fill your heart with so much joy and happiness. Maybe a moment with your child, a moment with your spouse. Or you just went to some trip and you felt immense, immense, immense joy in the nature. Just recall that and say thank you, thank you, thank you. Now imagine the blue, white and golden three light coming from the heavens above. Through your crown chakra entering to you. And now it's flowing through your conscious and subconscious mind, your brain, your third eye chakra, your face, your throat chakra, Visuddhi chakra, and it's purifying each cell in your body. Now going through your hands, your fingers, like going through your spine and your chest area, going through your heart, going through your digestive system, your stomach, your intestines, purifying each cell in your body, healing everything, removing the toxicity and toxic thoughts from your body, taking it along, this white, golden and blue light is taking all your worries away. Now going through your thighs, your knees, your calf muscles, and through your feet, it's going into the Mother Earth. Yes, you are free. You are love. You are peace. You are harmony. You are powerful and radiant. Magnificent being of life. Thank God for everything that you have currently and you are going to receive in the future. Now imagine one of your closest dream is coming true. Let's imagine that. How are you feeling? How are you feeling when it's going, when it's coming true for you? Who is the first person that you're telling after your dream is completed? You're sharing your joy, your laughter, you're celebrating your victory. And you're feeling at the top of the world. Feel that feeling. Bring that feelings into your imagination. Involve your five senses. How are you feeling? What are you seeing in that moment? What is the smell that is around? What is the touch that you feel? When you get your things done, Imagine the true feelings in you when you got your dream come true. Feel that joy right now. Feel that happiness. share that joy, share that happiness inside of you with others, with your loved ones and with the world. Now say thank you, thank you, thank you for this moment. Thank you. Now say to yourself, today is the best day of my life. I am the winner. I choose happiness and I'm happy. I flow through my days easily and effortlessly. Everything is coming to me easily. Life always supports me. Life always protects me. Universe has my back. I'm so grateful. Now, if you can do the abundance pose, just thank the universe for everything right now. Thank all the angels, guardians who are guiding you in this moment. Thank them. Now rub your palms, invite the energy, and bless each part of your body, your conscious and subconscious mind, your ajna, your eye, third eye chakra, your crown chakra, your eyes, nose, your mouth, your lips, your ears, your throat, your food pipe, your esophagus, your heart, your hands, your spine, your hips, all these digestive organs and excretory organs in your body, your thighs, your knees, your calf muscles, your feet, sole of the feet, toes. Say thank you to the trillions of cells in your body who is working relentlessly 24/7 to keep you alive. Say the gift of health is keeping me alive. Let's thank for all the money you have been given throughout your life, because you have been living a very good life currently, just because you have been given all sort of things that you needed and you could buy it because of the money that you received. So say thank you for the money I have been given throughout my life. Say thank you to those around you, the people who are making a difference in your lives every single day. Say thank you to those. Send blessings, love and light, abundance to them. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. You can come up. Okay, so how's everybody feeling today after the meditation? Anybody has any sharing?
Relaxed.
Relaxed, yes.
Yeah. And happiness.
Yeah. Thank you, Mommy, for sharing. Thank you so much. All right, then. Today I'm going. So I'll see you tomorrow. And yeah, one more thing. Actually, what I was thinking, it's only for weekend. So like I'm only working 5 a.m. on the weekend. So I can do one more thing. Instead of like waking up at 3:30 a.m. in the morning, I can take the class night here, which will be about 7 a.m. for you or 6:30 a.m. You all let me know what time is suitable for you, okay? 6:30 a.m. or 7 a.m., which will be around 10 p.m. here. So I thought yesterday that taking class at night will be much easier for me instead of waking up at 3 o'clock in the morning. Because if I have to take a class, I have to wake up.
Seven.
Saturday and Sunday, only 2 days. We'll do 6:30 or 7, anything. Okay.
7 a.m.
Okay, okay. Thank you. Yeah, yeah, we can do that. 7 a.m. is perfect for me. Everybody else, is the time okay for you?
Saturday, Sunday.
Yeah, only Saturday, Sunday.
Okay.
Okay, then. Please write in the group what time is suitable for you. Okay, thank you, thank you, thank you so much for joining in. And have a good one. Have a rest of the day. Good. Thank you.